Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back to another video where I create 10 cards using a card kit. This time I'm showcasing the new Spellbinders card kit. Just like always, it is packed with wonderful goodies. The theme this month is about Christmas and winter. It has a lovely color combo and let's take a look on what's included. In the kit you will always find a few ideas and instructions on how to create some of the cards. You will also get your adhesive both in tape as well as in foam. In the kit you will also get some dies. These dies are sentiments like Merry Christmas, and you also get dies that cut out little flowers and berries. As always in the kit you will find 10 white envelopes and 10 pre-folded cards. It is the standard size, that's 4.25 by 5.5. You will also get different sizes of gems. They are self-adhesive, so you can use them on your projects directly without using any glue, in lovely shades of blue and silver. There is also a sticker pack with lots and lots of stickers. Some of them are dimensional, so they are great as an embellishment on your cards. You will also get lots of silver stars and sentiments. And pretty much everything has a lovely silver foiling on top. You will also find a small stamp set that has lots of sentiments that you can use for this season, as well as a branch and some berries. And let's take a look at the pattern papers. This is a thin pattern paper. It is one-sided and it's 6x6. Now you will get lots of designs. Some of them have some lovely foiling, silver foiling on top. And you will find two pages from each design. But the thing that I'm always most excited about every month when I get this kit is to open up this die-cut bag. Now this is always packed with images that you can use as focal points on your cards. It has hundreds of them and for every design you get two of those. And you will find sentiments as well as images that have lovely foiling on top. You will find animals, snowflakes, stars, flowers, leaves, so many different elements, and I'm going to play today with all of them. And here is a look on all the different colors of cardstock that you get, and one of them is silver. So I'm going to start with the first card for today. I'm going to use the silver cardstock and cut it out into two panels so that I can use it later on. I chose to go with this wonderful pattern paper and I am securing on top a rectangle die so that I can cut out this panel. Now I'm going to play with the ornaments. I chose three of them from the kit. I'm adding foam tape at the back and I'm going to secure them on top of my panel. I'm making sure that I arrange them in different heights just to give some interest on my card. And then I'm going to use some white thread, thread it through the holes at the top of the ornaments and secure them at the back with some double-sided tape. And of course you can use any type of ribbon at the top of those ornaments, you can even tie bows. I decided to go in a simple design today. I have foam tape at the back of this panel and I'm going to stick that on the silver panel that I have. And finally I'm going to stick down my sentiment. So here are some close-up photos on the first card for today, and remember that you can always make duplicates of each card since you get everything twice. For the next card, I created again a rectangle panel which I'm going to stick on top of my silver cardstock there. And the panel, the pattern paper that I'm using on top, has lovely foiling on top of it. And now I'm going to create a flower arrangement. First of all, I'm picking up things that I think they match together from the die cuts, and then I play around, try to decide how they are going to go and how what is pleasing to the eye, and then I'm going to commit and stick everything down. For some of the die cuts, to add some dimension, I'm using foam tape at the back, and for other die cuts, I just use my glue and tuck them underneath. And to finish off my card, I'm going to add some foam tape at the back of the sentiment, which is again one of the die cuts, and just stick it there. All the cards that I'm sharing today are super easy to recreate, and I'm not using any other products than the ones that you find in the kit. So here I just cut out a piece from that pattern paper and I needed to use only this guy. And now I'm going to use that silver cardstock that I have left over. I'm going to cut out a piece. The idea here is to have a very thin strip of silver at the top and at the bottom of my pattern paper. So I'm just measuring out here how much I need. And I'm going to stick my pattern paper on top of the silver cardstock. And of course you can be more frugal than me, so you can just cut out two very thin strips of silver and just stick it on top of the paper to get the same result. I'm sticking this panel on my card base and it is off-centered, mainly towards the bottom, leaving more white space at the top. I'm going to add some foam squares at the back of my silver reindeer and I'm going to stick him on top of my sky, as if he is flying. I'm also going to use the gemstones and add some sparkle on my card, creating a little trail for my reindeer. And you can embellish the design even more if you use the silver stars that are included in the kit as well. I decided to go more tone on tone, and you will be able to see how wonderful it looks in the close-up photos. And finally, I used one of the sticker sentiments that says Merry Everything and it is silver foiled. Now, in many of my cards, I like to use rectangle dies to cut out perfect rectangles, but that's not a problem if you don't have any of those dies. You can just use your paper trimmer like I'm doing here. So here I'm cutting out a smaller panel, which I'm going to place on top of the pink cardstock that I have. The pink cardstock is 4.25 by 5.5, by the way. And for this card, I'm going to play with the dimensional stickers. It has this lovely little mouse inside the mitten, which I'm going to stick directly at the center of my card. And hopefully you can see how dimensional this one is. And I'm going to finish it off by sticking one of the sticker sentiments that says from our home to yours. A quick and simple card to make, but it's absolutely adorable. For my next card, I'm going to work directly on my card base and I'm going to create a little arrangement with that snow globe as well as a few die cuts that I have. Now, first of all, I'm starting with a sentiment and I went with the one that says Merry Ho Ho Ho. I'm going to stick on top one die cut with foam tape at the back, 4 dimension. And then I have cut out those 3 white flowers. These are cut out with the dies from the kit. I'm going to stick them on one side of the snow globe. And finally, I'm going to embellish the card even more by using some of the branches that were in the die cut pack in different colors. I'm going to finish off my card by adding some gems at the center of the white flowers for some extra sparkle. And here are some close-up photos on this card. For my next card, I'm going to create a little scene. I picked up this pattern paper as my background, and out of white cardstock, I created a couple of slopes. For the first snow slope, I used tape to stick it directly on top of my pattern paper, and for the second one, I'm using some foam tape at the back to add some dimension. Now, notice that out of the foam tape that they give you, I'm using both the negative and the positive ones, so not only the little squares, but also the outside, the outline. I just like to make the most out of it. And now I am going to arrange 3 of the die-cut trees. I picked up 3 different colors and they are all in different sizes, which makes the card look more interesting. For this tree, I'm going to use some foam tape at the back and stick it underneath the front snowbank. And for the other trees, I used tape so they look as if they are far at the background. Now for the sentiment, I used the dies from the kit to cut out Merry Christmas out of my leftover silver cardstock and I'm going to stick that on my card. Finally, I'm going to stick this panel on my card base and I'm going to call this card done. And moving on to another quick and simple card to make, I have cut out a piece of this lovely pattern paper. I love the foiling on it. It has lovely silver stars. And I'm going to combine some of the die cuts, like I'm going to stick this die cut on top of the snowflake, and then on top I'm going to stick the circle by using foam tape at the back. This way I'm creating kind of a snowflake medallion with number 25 on top, which is going to be the main embellishment, the focal point of this card. I'm going to stick that down, and all I need to do now is to stick a sentiment. For that I went with a merry ho ho ho, and my card is finished. And I am going to lift the card and try to catch the light for you so you can see how wonderful this pattern paper is. Okay, so today I'm in a mission to make the quickest cards ever. So here I'm using this wonderful pattern paper and I'm going to cut out a strip, and then I'm going to arrange on top of it the three silver reindeers. I put them in a row as if they are about to start flying, and the first one is up in the air already, and this is going to be my Rudolph. So I'm going to stick a red confetti on his nose, and I'm going to complete my card by sticking a sentiment that says, "You had me at ho ho ho." I think this is adorable. Now I still have one more silver panel available that I haven't used. I'm going to stick on top a piece of pattern paper, making sure that I leave the silver border all around. And then I'm going to play with the leftover stickers. I don't want to have the greenery since I'm going to use my own. So I'm just using my scissors to cut it out, and don't be afraid to customize the stickers that you have. And I'm planning to use this snow globe as well, so I'm just placing it temporarily there, try to decide where this is going to go. And I'm going to embellish my card with some greenery. Now I cut out this using one of the dies from the kit and the green cardstock, and I have three of those. So I'm just going to stick them down. I like how they add texture and dimension on my card. And for the snow globe, instead of just sticking it down, I went with foam tape at the back to add some dimension. Now I think it looks lovely as it is, but I still have one more greenery that I cut out, so I'm just going to stick it there as well. And finally I'm going to finish off my card by sticking a gem at the center of each and every one of those stars at the background paper. This is going to add some extra sparkle and more interest on my card. And we have reached the last card for today, so number 10, and I am creating again a little cluster using die cuts from the kit. I'm going to play with this ticket and I'm going to embellish it with flowers as well as some greenery. So this is going to be the focal point, and that's why I'm going to add some foam tape at the back to pop it up, and then everything else is going to be tucked underneath. And with the die cuts in the kit, you can easily create similar cards since you get lots of flowers and greenery to play with. To finish it off, I used one sentiment sticker that says, "May all your Christmas wishes come true." And here are some close-up photos on the last card for today. And now let's take a quick look on all the 10 cards that I made for today using products from the latest card kit by Spellbinders. It is a kit that I absolutely recommend. It costs $38.50. It's a great value for money, and I still have lots of products that I haven't used, and I didn't even use the stamp set. So thank you all so much for joining me today. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget that you will find all the links that you need down below in the description area. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and also leave me a comment and let me know which one of those cards was your favorite. See you all next time.